Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. There was another large earthquake that struck Turkey, not too long ago. About an hour and a half ago, but maybe 2 hours after I get this video posted. They're saying it was a magnitude 6.3. The Mediterranean seismic group says it was 1.2 miles in depth, which means there would have been even more damage, extreme damage, because it was so shallow. Currently, the death toll there in Turkey and Syria is at least 46,000. USGS gave it an intensity level of 8. There has been reports of more buildings that came down. Here it says intensity level 8, panel walls thrown out of frame, fall of walls, monuments, chimneys, sand blowholes, mud ejected, drivers of autos disturbed. They are saying that this latest earthquake occurred near Antakya, and it was felt in Syria, Lebanon, and of course Turkey. Here's the location of that 6.3. This is what the area would have looked like before the earthquakes. Yeah, I'm doubt very much if any of this is still standing. Here is an image from ABC News of Antakya after the February 9th earthquake. And another clip from CNN of Antakya. Yeah, look at the devastation. Those poor people. It used to be a prosperous, beautiful town. Looks like we got a drone footage going up. You can see all the piles of rubble, the different buildings that just collapsed. Yeah, terrible, absolutely terrible. So going to Google Earth, here is Antakya, and this is the latest earthquake. Another street view of Antakya. Let's go down a little bit, because these are probably the high rises that ended up collapsing. Yeah, the apartment buildings. So very sad. This is near the main downtown. Let me bring this out. Let's exit the street view. You can see all the high rises through here. Yeah, and this here is the main hub of Antakya. It shook up Yellowstone. I believe it was at 1704 Universal Time. It came in probably about at least 15 minutes later. You can see that right there. There's a bigger view of it. There is 139 earthquakes on this map by USGS. Says here 6.2 miles in depth for the latest 6.3, but the Mediterranean seismological post says that it was actually 1.5 miles, and we'll come down. A lot of fives. I would not be surprised if they have a magnitude 9 earthquake coming. Yeah, with all these earthquakes, and they're still fairly large. Almost, majority of them are close to fives. 4.5, 5.3, 4.8, 5.0. Yeah, there's the 6.1. That, 6.0 it says here. That was on the 6th of this month. And okay, there's the 7.5. Okay, and there was another one. Let's see. Is that the main one? No, okay. 7.8 right there. And this is today's right there, the 6.3. Okay, and then there was a 6.7, same location. Yeah, 46,000 dead. Other reports have it as high as 47,000. You know, it's going to climb to probably about 50,000. Here we have a map of what's going on. We got the Dead Sea Fault down here. The Anatolian Fault. This is the East Anatolian Fault. So actually, the 6.3 was probably the Dead Sea Fault. I've been talking about how there has been some quakes going down here by Israel. And I would not be surprised if, you know, these faults are not triggered to have a large earthquake. And it's part of prophecy where they're in Israel. Fault opens up, splitting the city in half. Turkey is one of the most seismically active nations in Eurasia. The cause of the earthquake is the collision of several of the plates which make up the surface of the earth. Much of Turkey is on its own plate, the Anatolian plate. It is being squeezed by the Iranian plate, ramming into the Eurasian plate. Now that's up over here. I did a report about one large earthquake that was in Romania, up over here. So the force of the Arabian plate and the Eurasian plate, up over here to the top left, it's squeezing the Anatolia plate, which is forcing the Anatolian plate to move west. In 1939, there was an earthquake in Ernakan. That one was a magnitude 7.8, killing an estimated 33,000 people. The population nowadays is so much greater. So here's the location of the 6.3. We'll go to Erzincan, the location of that earthquake. That was kind of northeast right there. All right, let's bring this out. Get an idea. There we go. So the 7.8 was as strong as the one they had in Ernakan. So that other 7.8 was about 85 years ago. Here on Geoscope, now they got the moment tensor ball. I don't think that's accurate because you can see here how the fault during the earthquake, it moved going south. West, and then down here we got spreading, and again it moved southeast. Here's the felt reports. We got all the way to Cyprus. Let's see here, down to Iraq. Yeah, it was felt in Jordan. It was felt in Israel, Lebanon, and Egypt. Yeah, we definitely don't want a 9-point earthquake, and we definitely don't want, yeah, the Dead Sea Fault being activated. So, yeah, sending prayers to these poor people. Here's a drone capture image of the fault there along the highway that opened up, spreading. You can see it spreading. Yeah, I am really surprised that this overpass did not collapse. Another image, 30 meters in depth, which is about 90 feet. And you can see here how it separated and spread. Yeah, the tectonic plates actually moved apart, separated. Another image of the fault. You can see we got spreading up over here and spreading right there. Now, this image here says it was a 7.9, not a 7.8. UC Berkeley said it was a 7.8 originally. I believe these two earthquakes are the largest that's been recorded there. In another image, it says preliminary observations of surface rupture from the Turkey earthquake. And we got two spots. Let me zoom in here And I'll move it over a little bit. It's got an image of the road where the road shifted down here at the bottom. And then they got the different fault lines drawn out. And another image showing the stress that has built up over that area. Yeah, it's in red. Here's a clipping from what one scientist said. Evidently, the system extends southward and becomes the Dead Sea Transform Fault System running through coastal Syria, Lebanon, Israel, and Jordan to the Red Sea. Dolan said some of the seismic stress from Monday's quake in Turkey have been transmitted to the northern end of the Dead Sea Transform Fault System. About 900 years ago, there was a series of large magnitude earthquakes that propagated from the East Anatolian Fault from the north going to the south. The quakes ruptured the fault in the same area hit on Monday over the decades. There were half a dozen powerful earthquakes moving southward on the fault system through coastal Syria into Lebanon, Donald said. Ultimately, culminating a very large earthquake on the Dead Sea Transform Fault in 1202, mainly centered in Lebanon, but extending farther south. 1202? Yeah. So, what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please make sure you're still subscribed. YouTube seems to continually unsubscribe people from your favorite channels. Please share and thumbs up this video. That will help with the ranking. Anyways, yeah, those poor people. God bless you all. Please be prepared. And many blessings through this week. Bye.